Right now we have Scamp versus 8-Bit Zeppelin. Fun fact, Scamp, his real name is David, but he goes by Dave. And if you guys have ever heard of Dave's Stupid Rule, Scamp is actually the creator of that rule.
Right, right. Scamp's been around for a long, long time.
He's a super OG, dude.
And if you guys don't know what Dave's Stupid Rule or DSR is, it's when you're counterpicking stages. Say game one, I won on Smashville. Game two, you win. Game three, now it's my counterpick. I can't go back to Smashville because I've already won on it.
Yes.
That's Dave's Stupid Rule. Unless both players agree to it, of course.
But Scamps, I don't think he has played in a while. He's been busy traveling. He had a birthday recently. He's been pretty busy.
What is he, and, like 80?
Yeah, he's pretty old. I think 75 this year.
Oh, okay.
And he actually helped invent Super Smash Brothers.
That's crazy. I heard he was actually in the room helping the doctor give birth to Sakurai.
Yeah. True facts. But he hasn't been playing all that much recently. And Zeppelin has been putting in a lot of time with the 8-Bit crew. He recently picked up Pikachu, and it's been working out really well for him. Scamp is having a really hard time with this matchup.
Yeah.
And Zeppelin...
He's at sub 20%, and Scamp is already at full rate, or about to be at full rage.
Yeah.
But, you know, Yoshi is no character to slouch on. That is, like, one of the most, like, slept on characters.
Yeah.
And he has a huge comeback factor.
I think it's really just because Yoshi doesn't have good placings, even though he's such a good character and everyone knows it. Right. It's just really hard to justify, tier list-wise, you could say, putting him all that high, but he is really amazing.
Yeah, there's just, like, outside of, like, who is it, Poltergust, Denti, there aren't that many Yoshis nationally.
Yeah.
There might be a few more I don't really know of anymore, so.
Sky.
Oh, yeah, Sky, there we go. But Sky doesn't go out to tournaments.
That's
the problem. He's really good, and he lives, like, I mean, the Sky House has, like, Tyrant, has Zero.
Kame House, dude.
Yeah.
Well,
that house could be an anime.
Zeppelin actually took a long time getting rid of that stock, but... You know, he still hasn't taken all that much percent if he just keeps playing the way he has.
Right, that was really dangerous for Zeppelin with Scamp being at full rage. It's not that hard to make a comeback in Smash 4.
Yeah. That's true.
Oh, okay, I thought he got clipped from his jump.
Yeah, Scamp's... seems like he just... His moves aren't that well placed. Just seems like he's a little rusty. Zeppelin, I know that he's practices on this stage quite a bit because he really, really wants to get down... His quick attack cancels.
Right.
So he's very familiar playing here. He doesn't have him down just yet. But.
Yeah. He's trying. They're pretty hard to do, though. Like, they're not as lax as it was before the patch.
Yeah.
Where you had to, you could kind of just be in the range of it, and then you'd slide off. Now the timing's a lot more strict. And so when you, oh, there we go. He's got it right there.
You gotta practice during the match, man.
Yeah. That served no purpose outside of him just doing it.
Those are the moments where you wish you still had heavy skull bash, but the up smash will do it, dude.
Right.
Extremely strong move. Pretty clean right there. I think it's going to be an easy game, too, for Zeppelin on this Scamp.
You know, as long as he's able to adapt and change it.
He needs to buckle down.
Yeah.
And remember how we played before his long break. Get his hands warm, you know. Mm-hmm.
That's why it's really important to get to a venue, to get to a tournament a little bit early and warm up. There have been too many times where, like, I've come to a tournament and I haven't warmed up, and I've either been, like, knocked in the loser super early, like round two, or, like, I'm just struggling to get by. So you definitely want to have those hand warmers. And also it's a mental warm up too.
My favorite way to warm up is I'll sit down and play, and I'll time basically how much time it takes for me to start feeling like I'm playing really well. Mm-hmm. And then... It'll be like, oh, well, I'll play, like, six sets or something. And then as soon as I get to, like, five sets, I'll be like, okay, stop.
Okay, yeah.
I'm right there at the gateway to where I'm about to start playing really well. Go into the next match, like, take some time to get, like, mentally stable, prepare to go in there.
For me, like, it's, like, the same way. Like, it takes a little bit of time for me to get into my groove.
Yeah.
So what I'll do is I'll play friendlies, and I'll play for about 30 minutes or so.
Yeah.
And then as soon as I feel myself, like, kind of getting into it, I'm like, okay, I'll stop. And then I'll start, the tournament will start, and as the bracket is going by, I'll gradually get better and better in terms of, like, how I'm feeling and how I'm playing. And oh, nice.
Oh, Scamp barely makes it back there. Zeppelin had some really sweet power shields earlier. He's been on point with those.
And I think the gradual thing is also good just for your momentum. You don't want to be complete. I mean, you want to for just for like your yourself, but you don't want to be completely dominating your first couple of rounds.
Yeah.
Because then all of a sudden,
you can
like
save that energy.
Right. And all of a sudden, quarters hit, and you're playing against like say Trayvante, right? You're not going to be able to be dominating him like you've been dominating these other players. And so just even if it's really close, even if you win, you feel like, oh shoot, that was really close. I can't be, like, I was just dominating. Why is it so close now?
Dude, Zeppelin was really close to the ledge, but did not quite make it back right there. You know what I haven't seen a lot of out of Zeppelin is that doing a falling forward air into either grab or up smash.
Oh, right.
That can get you a lot of percent. Especially since Yoshi, like, he's decently comboable. But, looks like he likes to use a lot of nair.
Yeah, and Scan taking advantage of the fact that Zeppelin has been struggling to get kills for the last three stocks.
Yeah.
Ooh, nice shield.
Yeah. I'd like to see him go for it.
And that, wow, up throw down B, hitting him with a 3DS combo.
Yeah. I'd like to see a lot more up smash since he's been really good with these power shields.
Yeah.
It's a lot faster than going for
Scamp like, really needs range. To work on his short hopping. He's doing a lot of like full hops, and it's not getting him anywhere. And especially with Pikachu being a very small character.
Yeah.
You're not going to be able to catch him.
Ooh, Scamp looking for that spike.
Yeah, probably thought that he was going to air dodge right near the edge.
Zeppelin really wants that jab combo. They end up getting the reset.
Scamp keeps on going for these dash attacks, but they're not working out for him. He's got to change up his game and know that every time Zeppelin gets hit, he rolls away. Or, yeah, he basically, like, you know, when you're in a kind of like tech motion, you just tech away or something.
Yeah.
He does that, or whenever he comes near him, he just rolls away as well.
Yeah, it's becoming kind of obvious that Zeppelin is still fairly new to Pikachu. And he doesn't know how to use all of his resources perfectly just yet. Yeah,
okay,
there you go.
That's going to be it right there. Scamp, you know, he did a lot better. I think it was part due to Zeppelin's SD, but
yeah.
He started getting back in the groove a little bit.
He did pretty good. I'm interested to see